Ronald McDonald family room because I had my first son in September, and he was 7 weeks early, so he spent 7 weeks at UNMH in the NICU and ICN nurseries. I had had a relationship with the Ronald McDonald House because I have a restaurant that had come to the Ronald McDonald House to volunteer and cook for the families who stayed there. So as soon as the director heard about my premature baby, she called me and let me know about the family room. And it was great because it gave me a place to go visit away from the beeping monitors and the stress of, you know, not knowing how your baby's doing every day. It's really hard sitting there with these monitors flashing these numbers all the time that you can't help but look at, even though the nurses say, don't look at those numbers, don't look at those numbers. And sometimes you just need to walk away and you need space to relax and breathe and have a cup of tea and read a book and just take a break. The Ronald McDonald House was already a really special organization to me and my family because we had seen firsthand what they provide for families all over New Mexico who have children in the hospital. I never thought that I would be one of those families, and I'm fortunate to live very close to UNMH, but to learn about the additional services that the family room provides, that really meant so much to me and my husband and my family. It gave me a break, and that was something that was really special and meaningful during that 7 weeks. Oh my gosh, my makeover day, that was so much fun. First of all, it was the longest time that I've been away from the baby, or probably my house, since he came home in October. I feel like I've been through a lot over the past 6 or 7 months, so I was looking for a change, and this was perfect. I was pampered. I had color and a fun new haircut, a relaxing facial. I got my makeup done, which I felt like I looked in the mirror and looked so pretty. It was really fun and special. I loved it.
My name is Viviana Olivas, mother of Osmar Avalos. The Ronald McDonald came into our life because of my son's therapies. He is deaf, so I bring him to therapies here to Albuquerque, and he gets service done here for his cochlear implants. He actually has cochlear implants, so he comes out here and he gets therapies, and they help him out to learn how to talk, his speech, and how to use his cochlears. And I am thankful that we actually knew about the Ronald McDonald House, or not, my son wouldn't have the option to come over here. I struggled so much, and it was to find a good therapist for my son. But knowing that the Ronald McDonald's here, and with my son's condition, we have the opportunity to come over here, and I can do better for him and find him the best therapist there is. Oh my goodness, he is. He started out, he wasn't born deaf, but he lost his hearing like probably a year ago. And he's had his cochlears for a year as well. And he is just talking his little brain away. He says, love you. He says, stop, mom. He's not at the stage he should be at his age, but he's getting there. He's not far from where he has to be. So he is my little boy. He is everything to me. Yeah. I'm so proud of him. You're gonna make me cry. Yeah, I'm proud of my son.
My name is Amy Gutierrez, and I'm the mother of Caitlin Gutierrez. I just turned 16. She was diagnosed with a rare brain tumor called a craniopharyngioma when she was 10. So we've been battling the brain tumor for about 5 years. The Ronald McDonald House has been absolutely instrumental in our survival through this journey, Caitlin's journey. It provided us not only a nice, safe haven, but it also provided us a very sweet and comforting place to be when we went into hospital with our child, because it's not just a place to stay, it's home. And so when we were going through the chemo and radiation and 7 brain surgeries, it was our home. And being from southeastern New Mexico, we were so far away from friends and family, and we had nowhere else to go. And so we didn't know about it the very first time. So we went through a week and a half of staying the night, our night in the ICU, pediatric ICU, for 2 weeks straight. And then the second time around, when the tumors had grown back, someone asked us if we would be willing to stay. We were hesitant to leave, and now we can't wait to get back. We can't wait to see what everyone else is doing and how everyone else has been. But for us, it was that the only place that we knew to go, and we wouldn't have been able to survive without it.
I had heard about the Ronald McDonald House, but I really never knew what they were all about until October 2009. I remember the day I was sent home on bed rest, and I was called later that evening, and I was told, pack a bag, because we're arranging an emergency transport to Albuquerque. And I said, for what? And they said, because you're gonna have the baby tonight. When I woke up out of surgery, all I asked my husband was, because I didn't even know that I would make it to a point where I would actually meet the baby. But I was just so relieved when he came in and told me we have a Sienna. So she was pretty compromised from the beginning. She was 3 pounds, a little bit over 3 pounds, 3 pounds, 1 ounce. At the time, the doctors and nurses said, you know, this is what Sienna needs. She needs round-the-clock care, which she gets here. She will get that here. But if you can be here as frequently as you can during the day to feed her and be with her and check on her status, that would be great. At the time, when they called over the Ronald House, we got to talk to them, and they said they had really limited availability, but they had room for us. And so when we got there, they explained that this is what they have to offer, and which really was a godsend, because I was able to practically live at the Ronald McDonald House for that month and a half that Sienna was in the hospital, to have a place to stay where I didn't even go home during that time at all. I never left Albuquerque. Well, like I can say, they're a godsend in our lives, I feel. They were a comforting place to go. They were definitely, they offered a lot of networking, because they were families who were in similar situations who were staying there. We met so many different people who were facing similar struggles. She knows that it just comes as second nature to both of my daughters now, just to go back to Ronald McDonald House, which even now we go back every year. We make it a point to go back every year, because I want them to give back a little bit of what we can do for somebody else that the Ronald McDonald House did for us.